Hi, good Wednesday to you. The brilliant sunshine, it's just too brilliant, I think. It's just a little too much sunshine here in Tucson. We're feeling bad for you guys up north. We are hearing that it's going to be a cold, cold week with maybe some snow flurries. In fact, a lot of snow up in North Dakota. So we pray for you guys constantly that we don't have to experience that anymore this winter. So anyway, good luck to you. God bless you. Today I'm in the sunshine. And we're dealing with the book of John. John is the metaphor man. Seven I am statements, including the I am statement of I am, he says at one point. We'll get to that. And in that, he declares that he is divine, but we'll get to that a little later. And today it's going to be I am the bread of life. Chapter 6, verse 25. Now, what sets this up is in the same chapter, just earlier. Jesus feeds the multitude. The only story, miracle story, that occurs in all three, or I'm sorry, all four Gospels, the only one. But John puts it in, and then he goes on to talk about the bread of life. He feeds them physically, materially, and then he goes on to talk about eternal fulfillment and filling. Verse 25 of chapter 6 of John. When they found Jesus on the other side of the lake, they asked him, "Rabbi, when did you get here?" And Jesus answered, "I tell you the truth, you're looking for me, not because you saw miraculous signs, but because you ate loaves and had your fill. Do not work for food that spoils, but for food that endures to eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. On him, God the Father has placed his seal of approval." This sounds a little uncomfortable if you look at it. Because the question of the crowd was interesting. What must we do to do the works of God? In fact, Jesus makes me a little uncomfortable up earlier, and they ask him, "Rabbi, when did you get here?" Jesus said, "You came because you saw the loaves and fish. Do not work for food that spoils, but for food that endures to eternal life." Is Jesus insinuating that we work? We work for our spiritual food, we work for our salvation and eternal life, which is contrary to everything we believe, to the core of our bones, about being saved by grace through faith, and nothing that we do. And so at first, you might, a reader might get a little disturbed by that. He's seeming to say, yes, work for eternal life. But then the crowd says this. Then they asked him, "What must we do to do the works God requires?" They heard him say works, and they're going, "Okay, that makes sense to us. We've been working all these years, obeying the law, trying to serve God." But asking Jesus, "What must we do to do the work God requires?" And Jesus responds, "Do good things, pray, be kind person." No, that's not it. I'm just joking. That's where many people go. What does Jesus say about what must we do to do the work God requires? And Jesus said, "The work of God is this, to believe in the one he has sent." There we go. Now that, don't you feel better now? It's not this contradictory to everything we know Christianity is, saved by nothing that you do. Now in Christianity, we are saved by works, but it's the work of Jesus Christ, not our work. And it's in us believing in the work of Jesus. In that we find eternal life. Whew. Isn't that interesting, though? The work of God is this, to believe in the one he sent. There's no work involved at all. In fact, John also says these things in chapter 6, verse 43. "No one can come to me," Jesus is speaking, "no one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him." That's not talking about a work that you do. It's talking about having a spiritual enlightenment, coming to see Jesus. Now, he repeats almost the same thing, almost word for word, in chapter 6, verse 63, or 65. Jesus went on to say, "This is why I told you, no one can come to me unless the Father enables him." No one can come to me unless the Father enables him. Now we're back to basic Christianity. God draws. Sinners are so far gone, blind and dead, that they would never come to believe that they're sinners and Jesus Christ is the Savior, unless the Spirit of God, through the Word of God, brings that truth home as a revelation. We're saved by the works, but it's Jesus' works. Heavenly Father, thank you for your works, that you have given the payment that that you should receive from your death and resurrection, and you've applied it to us. Thank you, God, that we are saved by grace, that your Spirit has drawn us to faith. Draw people also in our world that do not know Christ yet. Draw them to Jesus Christ through repentance, and may they come to know the works that you have performed on their behalf. I pray for all of us that you'd open up doors this week, this month, so that we might be able to serve you. Give us opportunities to love others in need, but also to speak a word of the gospel, to witness if a door opens, and please open doors for that. I pray for everybody listening. Would you bless them today and empower them and inspire them, and may your holy angels be with all of us to protect and shield us from the evil one and from danger and harm. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Have a great day. Just remember, let's glorify Jesus Christ. Ciao.